Happening right now, we are learning more about the fatal glider crash that killed three people in Stowe last night. The glider went down on Sterling Mountain after taking off from the Morrisville Stowe Airport. Tonight, police have released the names of the victims. The pilot has been identified as 70-year-old Donald Post. Local 22's Brittany Kelson had the chance to interview Post just this past summer. For the latest on the crash, we go live now to Local 22's Courtney Kramer at the airport. Courtney, what can you tell us tonight?
Good evening, Bernie. Police tell me the pilot, 70-year-old Donald Post, was also the owner at Stowe Soaring. His passengers have been identified as 58-year-old Frank Moroz III and his wife, 56-year-old Suzanne Moroz, both of Hamden, Connecticut. Thursday morning, crews returned to Sterling Mountain, working to recover the three victims killed in Wednesday's glider crash.
Today is recovering the bodies and bringing them out. They will be transported to the OCME's office in Burlington for autopsy. Morristown Police Department is handling the death investigations, and the Vermont State Police, along with multiple agencies, are assisting in the search and recovery mission.
The glider was owned by Stowe Soaring, a business operating out of Morrisville Stowe State Airport, offering daily rides above the Green Mountains.
They took off from the airport here in Morrisville at approximately 11:30 a.m. yesterday. The glider was disconnected from the plane at 11:50 around Spruce Peak, and the crash site was located last night at about 9:35 p.m. on Sterling Mountain.
Police say the scene of the crash is in a densely wooded area just about a mile up from the trailhead here, but nearly 1,500 feet up in elevation. To reach the site, crews could be seen taking several trips up and down the mountain in four-wheelers equipped with rescue apparatuses. The pilot, 70-year-old Don Post, is well known to the Stowe community.
From what I've gathered, he is an experienced pilot.
And although police cite Wednesday's windy weather conditions, it will take some time to determine a specific cause into the crash. But police do say they don't anticipate any charges in the incident.
No, there'd be no charges. I'm sure it's an accident.
At this hour, no word from police if they have completed the recovery process. Now, the Federal Aviation Administration and the National Transportation Safety Board will be investigating the cause of the crash. For now, live in Morristown, Courtney Kramer, Local 22 News.